China wanted to abduct two Australian journalists, but its hostage attempt failed as Australia rescued them successfully. China and its distasteful hostage diplomacy is a well-known fact, and despite being repeatedly called out on the world stage for it, the Red Regime, more often than not, uses this repugnant route to settle political scores. But a story of some extraordinary presence of mind from the Australian authorities has come into the light, which eventually thwarted Beijing's plan to abduct two Australian reporters in an attempt to get back at Canberra over the souring bilateral relations. Bill Birtles of Australian Corporation and Mike Smith of Australian Financial Review were the two journalists who had a narrow escape from the clutches of the Chinese security agencies. Reports said that Australian diplomats, after sensing some provocation by Chinese agencies, advised Birtles, ABC management, as well as Mike Smith last week that they should leave China immediately. While Bill was having farewell drinks with his friends in his apartment last Wednesday, with a scheduled departure flight on Thursday, seven Chinese police officials stormed into his apartment and said that he cannot leave the country and would be later questioned over a national security case. Bill, sensing the danger immediately, contacted Australian consular officials who collected him and took him to the Australian embassy, where he spent the next 4 days. Mike Smith, who is based in Shanghai, also received a visit by police, prompting him to go to the Australian consulate there. Both men were questioned over detained Australian news anchor Shang Lei. Ultimately, they both were allowed to leave the country in exchange for agreeing to be interviewed by police. Australian Foreign Minister Marisa Payne said that consular officials had assisted the pair in returning home. She added, "I also want to note that Australia is, of course, a strong supporter of media freedom, freedom of the press, and it is disappointing that after many years, Australia will not have a media organization present in China for some period of time." Birtles, after returning to his native country, showed his relief and iterated, "It's a relief to be back in the country with genuine rule of law. But this was a whirlwind and it's not a particularly good experience." Interestingly, Shang Lei, who was working for the Chinese state-run media outlet China Global Television Network, has also been detained in Beijing amidst heightened Sino-Australian tensions. Lei has been detained in a highly arbitrary manner. Initially, she wasn't charged with any offense, but was kept under residential surveillance at a designated location. But now Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Zhao Lijian said that the government detained her on national security grounds. However, he gave no details about the accusations. Such arbitrary detentions are an example of how unsafe China can be for foreign workers and tourists. And unlike Birtles and Mike, she didn't have the opportunity to inform the embassy. Australia has been at China's throat ever since the coronavirus pandemic began. The bilateral relations between the two nations have gone into a tailspin since it started emerging that China had clawed its tentacles deep inside the Australian way of life. China had methodically created a power nexus under the nose of previous Australian regimes. And it is not only Australia and its reporters that the authoritarian regime of China has looked to arrest. Even the Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has hit out at China on numerous occasions for arresting random Canadians and pursuing diplomatic goals. Canada's outburst against China is based on the detention of two Canadian nationals, Michael Kovrig, a former diplomat, and Michael Spavor, a businessman. They were arrested by Chinese authorities in December 2018. This is particularly detestable because it is a tit-for-tat measure against the arrest of Huawei chief financial officer Meng Wanzhou by Canada in December 2018 on an extradition request from the United States. Wanzhou is the daughter of Huawei founder Ren Zhengfei. She was arrested by Canada over US allegations of violating trade sanctions on Iran. So Beijing decided to pick up random Canadian nationals on espionage accusations. Till June this year, no charges were framed against them, and worse still, Beijing had even withheld consular access to the two Canadian citizens, citing coronavirus lockdown of prison. Beijing targeting two journalists who were going about their normal reporting duties is both regrettable and disturbing. It once again proves that China can go to any length to massage Xi Jinping's fragile ego. China's hostage diplomacy is ultimately going to cost it heavily. International tourism forms a major part of Chinese economy. Between 2008 and 2018 itself, it brought $127 billion for China in foreign exchange. But it seems that Beijing is pushing the democratic world to destroy another Chinese sector due to its primitive ways.